Network is the best in the game. We now join Prime Network programming.
Hold it, Robin. One second, please. Sorry. Let me soak
you
in.
I didn't want to disturb you with speech.
Oh, yeah. That's what I need.
Hey, Leslie.
Hey, Leslie.
How you doing?
Hi, Betsy.
Hey, Betsy. Hey,
yes, me.
The new star of Howard's favorite show.
Okay.
The only show there is.
That's true. It is the only show on television now. Did you hear that they're going to make an all Baywatch network?
Oh, yeah, right. All Baywatch all the time. What's that scary fact? Isn't like Baywatch is on in 72 countries and seen by like 90 million people a day. There's some fact that
it's like 104 countries.
Yeah, right. It's like,
and it's
right.
400 million people a day.
Bring in Yasmeen Bleeth. She's corrected us.
Yasmeen?
Yasmeen.
Yasmeen?
She must be some kind of Persian or something, which is Iranian. Mm. When Iranians come to this country, they call themselves Persian.
Hey, wouldn't you?
So, yeah, so we don't know. Everyone's going, man, she's really hot. Which is good for her because I'll tell you something. I had this Nicole Eggert on my show. She was the girl on Baywatch before Yasmeen.
Yes.
And these girls go nuts. They start to think that they're big stars. They can walk away from Baywatch.
Well, I even hear Pamela Sue Anderson now.
Well,
she doesn't want to talk about
hold
her.
Hold it, Robin. One second, please. Let me soak you in.
I didn't want to disturb you with speech.
Oh, yeah. Ooh. That's what I need. I need you. I need to marry you today.
Give the girl a chair.
What?
Aren't you married?
No. As a matter of fact, my wife died of cancer. God rest her soul. Yeah.
That's very unfortunate.
She died of brain cancer.
Ooh.
She died yesterday.
Okay. And you're ready just to move on now.
Well, I have to date. I have children. I need a mother for my children. And you're it. Here, take a seat. Let me look at you and then take a seat. Man, what a body. Why are you wearing pants? Why don't you just wear a jacket with no pants?
Because I'm going for the sophisticated look. I'm playing against type.
No, everyone's sick of the sophisticated look. Yeah. Everyone just wants to see you.
That's right.
Everyone thinks they're Katherine Hepburn now. Why is it a beautiful woman can... I mean, you're a good actress. Just sit down.
She uses her body to make money. She doesn't have to come in here and show it to you.
Why? Maybe I'll put her in my movie. You know what? I want you to play my wife in my movie.
You do?
I certainly do, and it's a major motion picture.
Absolutely. Well, you know what?
My wife is not a blonde.
On that topic, the casting directors of Baywatch, Fern and Susie, would like to cast your new movie. They told me. They said they have excellent taste.
No, Avi is casting my movie. They hired my studio already hired a casting person. I just handed in the script yesterday. They've already hired a casting person. How do they do that?
I don't know. Sorry, Fern and Susie. I tried.
Avi's doing it. I want you to audition. Now, if you're my wife, we have a scene where you kiss me and you hug me a lot.
You see that poster behind you? That's the part right there.
Yeah, okay. That's you.
That actually looks like me a little bit.
That does look like you.
It does.
That is the poster for my movie. It's in my paperback, actually. And that is the final scene of the movie.
Okay.
As a matter of fact.
Well, I'll be there. You tell me the time. Okay?
Let me tell you something. It would serve your career very well.
No.
So your name is Yasmeen?
Yasmeen.
What are you, Persian?
I'm not Persian. Hey,
get close to that microphone. I don't want to miss a minute of your voice. Okay. I want to learn everything I can about you.
My mom was born in Algeria, but she was French from North Africa. So,
Yasmeen?
Yasmeen. Yes.
Yasmeen Bleeth is a real name?
Yeah,
no one would say the name Bleeth.
I know Bleeth with Yasmeen. It doesn't quite go, but I didn't change it.
It goes. I'll remember it.
So, how did you wind up on Baywatch?
Take a look at her.
Okay. How did they find her? You know, she just wasn't standing there at the door.
No. I auditioned last year for a guest spot.
Right.
And I got the role, and then it turned out that Nicole, who you were just talking about, she was leaving.
Let me explain something to you, so you understand this as well. This is Nicole. I met her.
Mm-hmm.
Personally, I think she's a little bit weird. Now, let me just say this. First of all, you are going on Baywatch because she is so misguided. She's going to leave. She's popular. She is more popular than she's ever been.
And more people know her name than they ever have.
I agree. I don't understand her reasoning, but I don't know.
Let me tell you something. Well, thank God, because now you have the Baywatch job.
That's true. Thank you, Nicole.
Nicole decided now she's going to be an actress somewhere. She was acting on Baywatch.
She got breast implants.
Yes.
Then got angry at the breast implants.
Yeah, she got angry.
Took them out. I know. That's a weird thing.
Isn't that weird?
That's very strange.
That's very strange.
I know.
Her breast implants were beautiful. They were the most.
It worked.
They were beautiful.
Nobody forced her to get them.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
A round of applause.
She felt she couldn't be a serious actress with the breast implants.
That never stopped anybody else.
No, it didn't. And I'm telling you that this girl should have stayed with this show, Baywatch, milked it for all it was worth, and gone hiatus. Go do movies because of your new fame and everything else.
Exactly. We only shoot 6 months out of the year. We have 6 months off to pursue
anything. 6 months to pursue anything. Do it. Go for it. She was becoming a very big star. Mm-hmm. Now she's sitting around, I guess. I don't know. Is she sitting around?
I really don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
But you are going to stick with the show.
I just started. I'm having a great time, and I don't see any reason
why. You're sure you're not going to change your tune?
And you have no problem being in a bathing suit?
No.
You enjoy being in a bikini?
Well, you know what? I haven't worn a bikini yet. I
wore really?
Just the one piece.
Wear a
so
bikini.
Far. All right. Next time for you, I'll wear
would you
a bikini.
Ever, would you ever wear a thong?
A thong?
Yeah.
No, you know what? I'm not a big thong lover.
No?
No, I don't think they're too attractive.
I'd love to get you in the sack. Oh, man. I don't
all
know what that would
here
be like.
Go. I've been here 3 minutes. You were just saying that to Juliette Lewis.
Yeah, Juliette Lewis is a boy compared to Yasmin. Now, you're a very attractive girl. Very obviously, beautiful. You know that. What, in high school, everyone was after you, and you're used to having guys fall all over you, right?
Yeah.
Now, why did you cover up your birth date on the...
She didn't want anyone to know how old she is.
You know, professional.
She wants
secrets.
To play young.
I know. I play 21 on the show.
Right.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Now, how long have you been in Hollywood?
In Hollywood?
34 years.
Oh,
<Howard? laughs> Seasoned veteran. Go ahead. Now, you were on the soap operas, right?
I was.
Oh, you were? Okay.
7 years total. Ryan's Hope and One Life to Live.
Now, someone told me you got on the soap opera because you were on the Psychic Friends Network or something.
That's wrong.
What? Tell me about that. What is this with the Psychic Friends Network?
Sloan, you were supposed to save me. That's my publicist.
Yes, well, forget him.
You were on the Psychic Friends Network?
Yeah.
You were with Dionne Warwick?
So with Dionne, yes, I was.
So what happened? You did the infomercial Psychic Friends?
I just got paid to do it.
But you don't believe in psychics, do you?
Actually, no.
I didn't think so.
Not at all.
But did you get a reading on the show and you...
Not on the show. We did call the psychic our personal psychic.
Yeah. Dionne's really wacky with that. I think she really believes it.
I think she does, too. She does.
But sad.
I just did it. I sold out. You know, it was great money for
but that's
few
not
years.
Selling out.
It's okay.
You mean you went on there, and what do you have to do?
I didn't be
do
testimonials.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe you did sell out.
I didn't say anything that wasn't true.
But what did you have to say?
I went on with my boyfriend.
Right. Who's your boyfriend?
Oh, here we go. He's an actor. His name's Ricky Paul Golden. He's starring in Grease right now on
Ricky
Broadway.
Paul Golden? Oh, I never heard of him.
Wait a minute. I just saw Grease.
Which he's nothing.
Danny Zuko.
Oh, he's gorgeous.
I know.
Oh, really?
Sorry, Howard.
Yeah, well, I have a personality. You could tell Danny Zuko that that unlike him, I have a personality. Maybe girls would find that entertaining after the shallowness of looks wears
exactly.
off.
After he starts to lose his hair.
I could never get sick of you.
Really?
I would worship you. You see, a good-looking guy doesn't worship you. A good-looking guy doesn't worship you. He worships himself.
Well, you
what
know,
I would
have
do.
To, I have to disagree.
I would consider. Okay. Oh, okay. We'll see if in 5 years he's still with you.
Okay.
You see if he doesn't dump you.
I'll come knocking, Howard.
No, you wait and see. Oh, then it's going to be too late. I offered you a date right now. Luke Perry?
Oh, my God.
How's he in the sack?
This weekend on E!, a brand new E! Features quiz show. Robert Redford directs Rob Morrow, Ralph Fiennes, and John Turturro. This weekend on E!, exciting original one-hour shows, scandals, shocking stories from Hollywood's past, Melrose Place, behind the scenes of TV's steamiest show. This weekend on E!, an in-depth hour, sex, sizzle, and sales, advertising goes Hollywood. All this weekend on E! Entertainment Television, the entertainment news and information authority. From Hollywood Pictures.
You have 21!
Critics are declaring Quiz Show the best American movie this year. Newsweek says with Quiz Show, the fall season gets off to an Oscar-contending start.
Dick thinks 21 is rigged.
Is it?
USA Today gives it 4 stars. Robert Redford's direction equals his Oscar-winning job on Ordinary People.
You lose when I tell you to lose.
I'm supposed to take a dive?
Joel Siegel calls it great filmmaking. Quiz Show will win a mantelpiece full of Oscar nominations.
Everybody got the
answers but you.
Siskel and Ebert give Quiz Show two thumbs up, and Gene Siskel calls it clearly one of the year's very best movies.
Sign this thing. Who cares if it's true?
From Academy Award-winning director Robert Redford comes an absolutely mesmerizing drama and one of the year's most provocative films. A sure contender for Best Picture of the Year.
If someone offered you all this money, would you do it?
Quiz Show is the must-see movie of the fall. Quiz Show, rated PG-13. Now playing in select cities. The Fresh Maker.
Are you a goody two-shoes, or you like to have some fun?
Me?
Yeah.
What do I look like to you?
You look like you're a goody two-shoes, but I think like maybe underneath.
You'd like to have some fun.
You get high at all? You get high? You like to smoke a little reefer?
Absolutely not.
Really?
Really.
You never got high in your life?
I can't answer that. My grandmother's
really?
Listening this
oh, your
morning.
Who's listening? Your grandmother?
I know. Hi, Nanny.
Hey, Nanny, Nanny. Hey, Grandma, you like to smoke crack? Ever do White Crosses, lewds, hash, LSD?
I don't even know what you're talking about.
Really? You don't get into that kind of stuff?
No.
So you don't party at all?
I party.
Do you like to drink a little?
A little.
Get out of your mind a little bit?
Baywatch girls have a reputation.
I know. Did you guys see that hard copy, The Bad Girls?
You're
going
to go to those clubs? Are you going to go to those clubs?
You got to be at the Viper Room every night.
Are you going to go to the Viper Room and die in front of the Viper Room?
Only if Johnny will come save me.
Do you ever date any famous guys? You have? Really?
Yes.
Who'd you go out with?
Who did I go out with?
Yeah, who'd you go out with? What's the big deal? You dated a guy. I'm not asking you what you did with him. I'm just asking, who are your boyfriend? Who did you used to date?
I dated a few people.
Jack Nicholson?
Yeah, I've been out with Jack. I've had his baby.
No, come on, really. Who did you date? who are your boyfriends? I'm curious. I want to know everything about Yasmeen Bleav.
Oh, Leslie, come save me.
You ever go out with Adam West?
Oh, Adam West Batman?
Yeah. Someone told me you were linked to him romantically. Oh, come on, seriously,
TV
what crowd?
Or movies?
Okay, TV.
TV's Grizzly Adams? Who are you with?
How did you know?
Now, come on, who are you with? Seriously, who is your boyfriend? There's nothing wrong with saying it.
Yeah, because I'm not supposed to talk about this.
Dated someone?
Howard,
you didn't have sex with them. I'm just asking you who you dated
Howard,
with.
Howard, this was your job. You were supposed to research me. It was been
no,
in
come
the
on, tell me. No, I don't, come on, tell me.
I can't.
I don't read tabloids. I'm one of the few celebrities that doesn't.
MacGyver.
No. Were you with TV's MacGyver?
No.
Were you with Bob Barker? For several years.
What are you linking me with these elderly gentlemen for?
I don't know. I'm asking you who you're with.
Guy?
Is it a young guy?
I'll tell you, I go for younger men.
Or who is it? Younger. Rob Lowe?
Rob Lowe, please. He's all
who is it, looking. Gary?
Got the list.
All right, who is it?
Oh, no.
What's the list?
Okay. Luke Perry?
Wait a second. Wait, go slow. Go slow. Russell, don't go. Wait a second.
One at a time.
Luke Perry?
Oh, my God.
How's he in the sack?
I can't answer this.
I know Luke.
You do?
But you just go for good look. Well, Luke was on soap opera, so you probably met him there, right?
Yes, I did.
And would you go out with him for a long time?
Yes, relatively long time.
You moved in with him?
did I? Vaguely.
Really?
Yes.
But he didn't deliver you the goods. In other words, he didn't satisfy you sexually.
Let's just say we were both too young.
So you moved out on him, or he dumped you?
What do you think?
He did. I think you dumped him.
There you go!
All right, next.
Come here and kiss me now, and I'll show you how a real man has sex.
Okay. Who's next on the list?
What? Yeah.
Big film star Christian Slater.
Oh, that's wrong. That's
really?
A complete lie.
Oh, yeah? You that care to take a lie detector?
Yes, I will.
Okay,
I will
and who is Grant Cho?
Oh,
Grant Cho is a real good-looking guy. Oh, the two of you must have made a handsome couple.
We were the best-looking couple on the block.
Grant Cho is the guy who is on Melrose Place, that blonde, that big, dumb blonde guy.
The other guy.
Big dummy. Big, empty-headed nut. How stupid is he on a scale of 1 to 10? Is he the Vanna White of actors?
No.
Does he have a big empty head? It's like,
why are you so angry at Grant?
Grant, want to make love?
Oh! Oh my God.
Did Luke get mad when he started losing his hair?
Luke is losing his hair?
I don't know. I don't know. He flipped his hair back on Beverly Hills 90210 last night, and I don't know. It looked like some hair.
He's always had that hair.
He does? Yeah. Yeah, he's a good guy. I like Luke. He's in my movie. I wrote him a part.
Did you?
You wrote everybody a part. You're asking me to be in your movie. He's in your movie. What's up?
Well, I just got a lot of people in mind for this movie.
Okay.
It's a lot of cameos. Mm-hmm. So you went out with Grant Show, and what happened? Now, he probably dumped you.
Absolutely. Well, you know, I don't remember. It was a long time ago.
How long did you live with him? Every good-looking guy. It's always got to be good-looking guys. Don't go out with ugly guys like me.
I don't know, Howard. You said in 5 years.
Yeah. Can't believe it.
But the thing is, it's true. You wouldn't be interested in 5 years. See, that's the sad thing.
No, I'm not interested in your personality. I mean, you're a very nice woman.
Vapid, too.
Yeah, okay. I'm a big, empty guy. You know what I mean? I don't go for a woman's personality. I'm a body man.
I understand that.
I like face and body the best.
Well, there you go. Maybe we would get
imagine
along
bringing
after
her, imagine bringing Yasmin to parties.
Oh, not to parties, to family events.
Family reunion.
Dad, this is Yasmin. Oh, yes, I'm on the new Baywatch. Yeah, Yasmin, you want to go swimming? Yeah. Oh, I'd love to take you to a party, a swim party.
Can I just tell you that families happen to love me? I do good with moms.
Oh, I'm sure you do.
You know, because that nice girl thing comes out.
Yeah, and then when you get into your bathing suit, and we go home, and we have to swim, relax in the pool.
Grease up, do the first unit oil, as they say.
I could see why they hired you. When you went for your audition for Baywatch, did they get you in a bathing suit?
No, sir.
Really?
What was the audition?
That'd be funny. Like then the first day on the beach, she gets on Baywatch.
Yeah, and I have cellulite and I weigh 400.
And like she just had her breasts removed.
Terrible.
You know what I mean? Like she just went through breast cancer. You know, like, wait a second, what is this?
I know, I probably.
Wow.
But she probably had photos, didn't you?
No. As I was saying before we got sidetracked, I don't know how that happened.
Yeah.
I auditioned for a guest spot last year, and they, no bathing suit, it was a dramatic
okay.
part.
Yeah, with David Hasselhoff had to drill through the sand with his head. Kissing. Would you ever kiss another girl on screen?
Sure.
You would?
Yeah, I'm an actress.
While you're naked.
Sex sells.
What makes you buy what you buy?
And more sex sells even more.
Find out by watching Sex Sizzle and Sales on E!
It's using another tool or medium for art.
Who is interested in sex?
Join host Christy Brinkley for Sex Sizzle Sales.
I like to take risks.
Watch Sex Sizzle Sales, premiering Saturday, September 24th at 6 Eastern, 3 Pacific on E!
From the director of Moonstruck.
Do you believe in destiny?
Destino.
Destino. Si.
To take a trip where the events are totally predetermined.
I'm getting a name. His name is Damon Bradley.
I'm Damon Bradley.
It's a coincidence.
It is not a coincidence. It's fate.
TriStar Pictures presents Marissa Tomei, Robert Downey Jr. Only You, rated PG. Starts Friday, October 7th at a theater near you. Exclusively at Saks Fifth Avenue.
Hi, I'm Alec Baldwin, and you're watching E! Entertainment Television. E!
Attention inventors. Receive free confidential forms and useful information on how to launch a new product, innovation, or just an idea by calling the Inventors Helpline in Washington, D.C. at 800-227-7000. Call now and you'll also receive a free brochure describing how you can participate in the invention process. Don't wait. Our free inventors package will get you going in the right direction.
Call 800-227-7000.
Discover Las Vegas magic. Excalibur Hotel Casino, located on the most exciting four corners of the Strip, with rooms for $55 Sunday through Thursday, now until September 29th. Enjoy six marvelous restaurants, non-stop family entertainment, King Arthur's Dinner Show Spectacular. Phone 1-800-937-7777. Excalibur, it will take your breath away.
Do you have to shave for the show?
Absolutely.
So you're completely clean shaven?
Not complete. I just do the bottom part of my legs.
No, I don't mean your legs. No, I don't know. I don't get this. I don't know. I just got to think about you. Man, you're not wearing a bra, are you? Look at that. Oh, yes, you are. Now I see it.
I am.
Oh, man. Are those real?
I was looking down my... Are they real?
Yeah.
Now's America. America always wants to know this. Yes, actually, they are. They are. Another round of applause.
Standing ovation.
Thank you. Okay. Because Nicole's were fake. She just got a regular applause.
Right, right.
Standing ovation.
Have you ever had sex with another girl?
No.
You would never consider that?
No.
What if a movie called for it?
A movie called for it?
Yes. Lesbianism.
Well, they're not going to show the actual sex. Like a kiss?
No. They're kissing. Would you ever kiss another girl on screen?
Sure.
You would?
Yeah, I'm an actress.
While you're naked?
No, you didn't say that.
Would you ever do Playboy?
No. I'm sorry. You look like you're about to cry, Howard.
All right, I'm going to end the interview then. So the guy who had sex with you first?
Yes.
Did he break up with you thinking he could do better?
No.
Broke up with him?
It was a high school thing. We grew apart.
Is he in a local bar right now, like, banging his head against the wall, drunk?
I don't know.
I did it first.
I do not know.
I did it first. You see how I did it first? That's my girl. I could have married that girl, and I did it.
The one on TV.
That's TV's Yasmin Brief.
She was Yasmin when I did her.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah,
that's good.
Where did it happen? In a car?
No. Do I look like the kind of girl to do it in a car?
That's precisely why you would. You've never done it in a car.
I actually haven't. I grew up in New York City. Nobody
if you were my girl, if you were my girl, you'd be doing it in cars.
He'd have brought a car.
Yeah, because I can't bring you home. My wife will kill me. Ever do it on the beach?
Your wife? You just told me your wife was dead. Howard.
She's technically. She's technically brain dead.
Okay. Since she died yesterday, he hasn't gotten used to it.
Yeah, it's not easy to talk about. Okay. You ever have sex on the beach?
Yes, I have, and that's incredible.
You were naked on a beach.
Yeah, on an island called St. Bart's. That was nice.
Freddie's shaking his head like he was there.
Yeah, Fred, what are you shaking your head about? She's not interested in you.
No, because I've done that, but not
oh,
with
you've
her.
Done that?
Not with her.
Yeah. You've done it with yourself on a beach, laying around naked.
He made a sand girl.
What about in an elevator? Ever do it there?
No.
So you've never done anything really dangerous.
Well, you know, that's just so cliche. That's not dangerous in an elevator.
You would do it with me in an elevator.
You in the Mile High Club?
You ever do it on a plane?
Yes. Vaguely. Yes. Vaguely on them. You know, almost.
Oh, so you serviced a guy on a plane.
I don't service
my.
People.
All right, take it easy. Does everyone calm down? Okay, all right, all right. Hey, a publicist just jumped out the window. What a guy. All right, listen.
First of all, she's a woman.
Oh, really?
Leslie Sloan, I called her.
Oh, Leslie you have. She's very talented. Very good. I like Leslie Sloan. Yasmin, what is it, Fafafuhai?
Actually, she's here with her publicist and her best friend, who are also, like, very good-looking.
Oh, really?
Good-looking click.
All right, but before I say goodbye, let me see the click.
Yes, come on. Come on, my entourage. He feels good, ladies.
Don't I? Come on.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Stern.
No, Mrs. Stern is dead.
Sex sells.
What makes you buy what you buy?
And more sex sells even more.
Find out by watching Sex, Sizzle, and Sales on E!
It's using another tool or medium for art.
Who is interested in sex?
Join host Christy Brinkley for Sex, Sizzle, Sales.
I like to take risks.
Watch Sex, Sizzle, Sales, premiering Saturday, September 24th at 6 Eastern, 3 Pacific on E!
Take a deep breath, count to 10, and get ready.
What is going on here?
To take the fall. Charlie Sheen.
Are you out of your mind?
Yes! Yes, I am!
Nastasha Kinski.
How do you stop this thing?
Terminal Velocity, rated PG-13. Starts Friday, September 23rd at a theater near you.
The fresh maker.
Esprit de la champagne.
I love that beat. Ordering.
J'arrive à avoir des croissants. C'est ça, c'est ça.
Esprit de la champagne.
Vous êtes vraiment dégoûtante.
Non, mais je rêve.
Esprit de la.
Mais tu perds ton temps, il donne que les mecs.
I'll do anything for that.
Très scorpion comme comportement.
Je le sens, j'en peux le dire.
Exclusively at Saks Fifth Avenue.
Tonight, it's a night of premieres on ABC.
I feel good.
With Roseanne and Ellen on their new night.
Well.
There's some big news on an all-new Roseanne.
Oh, my weakness. Animal noises.
Find out the best-kept secret of the new television season.
Something should stay between a husband and a wife.
Which one do you want to be?
Then Ellen's got a date with a dentist.
Are you feeling relaxed, Ellen?
Well, I feel downright tingly.
And wait till the laughing gas kicks in. An all-new Roseanne and Ellen tonight on ABC.
Oh, look at the troop.
Oh, here we go.
Let me guess who's who.
Okay.
Lady in the green outfit's the publicist.
Yes.
Leslie from PMK, our new friends.
Nice body.
Be
on
nice
you.
To her.
How'd I do? You're gonna ban me again for another 20 years?
And who's Betsy Goldstein.
Oh, Betsy, very nice.
I know.
I used to beg girls like you to sleep with me. You wouldn't. Either one of you. All right. Listen. Now it's time for the part of the program when we say goodbye.
Okay.
If you feel inclined, you can hug me goodbye. If not, I understand. I mean, if you're feeling turned off.
The problem is that I have to jump over the desk to do this.
Let me help you decide.
Okay.
I think for the following reasons you should hug me goodbye.
All right, I love this, the pros and the cons.
My paperback's number 2 on the bestseller list.
I thought it was number 1.
No, the book was number 1. It's just the paperback
just
was just released.
Out.
Give me right. a break.
It's okay. going to be number 1.
It's going to be number 1. It okay. just takes a second, all right?
All right.
I'm filming a major motion picture for Reicher Entertainment.
And
okay?
Were you going to give me a part in that or not?
Yes.
You were, okay.
Yes, I am, but I need to see how you fit in my arms.
Okay.
I had a whole big discussion with the movie people.
Yes.
I said, you know, one of my problems, like when I did the Gary Shanley show, I'm so damn tall, I don't even look like I'm in the frame. She said, don't worry, we can work that out. Everyone get on a soapbox and, you know,
you
and
should
stuff.
Get David Hasselhoff.
Everybody's
going to
be your height.
What?
Everybody's going to be your height?
Yeah, I want everyone my height. How tall are you?
5'5".
Well, that's the right height. We're only 37 inches apart. Yeah, that's perfect. And I've single-handedly made the E! Network number 1 with my TV show.
Okay.
Credentials, girls? Impressive?
Yes.
All right.
Very good.
So,
And that's it?
Well, okay. My genitals are in line with your shoulder.
Oh, that's always convenient.
That's right. And the highest-rated Tonight Show ever, and the highest-rated Letterman, even bigger than Madonna when I go on.
Oh, really? Well, that did it. Come
all right,
here, baby.
All right, no. You come to me. Come
okay,
here. Come here. Take your headphones off. Oh, good.
Here we go.
I'll be hugging TV's Yasmine Bleeth from Baywatch.
Okay, here we go. You have yourself all
here, hold on.
Locked in here.
Hold on. Ooh, what are you wearing, sandals?
I am. You see, I got a little skin showing.
You got. Hey, can I rub your leg? Hey, seriously.
No.
Here's all I want to do. Here's what I want to do. If it's all right with your publisher.
It was a hug.
No. First, I want it. Wait, come here. Come here.
Now there's a negotiation.
Oh, now the publicist is in on it. Now I'm ruined. No, I'm saying, can I put my hand on your calf and rub it? Would that be a...
I think that's pushing it. I think the hug was good.
Come on.
Let's do the hug and see where it goes
from there.
All
right, see how
you feel.
Come here.
Okay, here we go.
Just rub up and down.
Oh, here we go.
I'm just so lonely.
He feels good, ladies.
Don't I? Come on.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Stern.
No. Mrs. Stern is dead. Can I pull your bra strap?
No.
Oh, come on.
No.
Please, just let me just tug on.
Absolutely not.
Can I touch your leg?
No, that's enough. I'm actually
right,
leaving.
Right,
why
do you have
right
to
now?
Act
right.
like
Thank
a junior
you.
High school kid?
Because I'm never going to get anything off her otherwise.
What was up with that?
That's like
well, you know, you've got some very
adult entertainer.
My grandma's gonna kill me, first of all. You know, Aunt B and Aunt Faye in Florida, they're gonna have a fit. Pompano Beach over there.
You hang yourself every single time now, don't you?
I tried to get out of it. What was I supposed to do?
Here, Howard,
no comment.
Let me tell you more.
I was not undressing. I was not undressing.
I just gave him your diary.
I didn't.
Dan's called in and spilled the beans. I guess they read the Star a lot.
Is that how they did it? I thought you did like some quick research.
No. Somebody just calls in and says, oh, I know who it is. And then I write it down and throw it at you and you tell us whether it's true or not.
So I think it went pretty well overall.
I think it was fine.
You'll get a very good reaction off it. You really will.
I wasn't too
You'll jump in a cab and go, hey, would you just don't stir?